Hi, welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video lecture, let's discuss about the logical operator precedence and how to compute the complement of Boolean functions. Recall that we have three logical operators, which are not, and an or operation. And when these three operations occur together in a Boolean function, what is the order in which the operation will be evaluated? That is what is dictated by the operator precedence. For example, f is a Boolean function, which is an XOR function. So we have x y bar plus x bar y. Here we have two complements. Y bar is not operation. Again, x bar is not operation. And then we have AND operation between x and y bar and x bar and y. And finally, we have a OR operator. Okay, so how this will be evaluated? First, we have to evaluate the NOT operation, because NOT operation gets the topmost priority. So NOT operation will be evaluated first. So y bar will be computed. Similarly, x bar will be computed. And then the second priority goes to the AND operation. So we will compute x and y bar. Similarly, x bar and y, these two terms will get evaluated. And finally, we will apply this OR operation for this partial products. So that is what is illustrated in this figure as well. We compute y bar first. Only if we have y bar, then only we can compute this AND operation, which is x y bar. So we compute y bar first. That's why NOT operation get the topmost priority. And then we compute the AND operation. Similarly, we compute x bar here. Then we compute the partial product, which is x bar y. And then finally, we compute the OR operation, which is x y bar plus x y bar. So this is the order in which the operation will be evaluated. Given any Boolean function, NOT operation will be evaluated first, followed by the AND operations, and finally the OR operations. Next, let's see how to compute the complement of a Boolean function. Let f be the Boolean function, then the complement of the Boolean function f will be represented by f bar. In f bar, we will interchange all the zeros to ones. All the zeros in f will be switched to ones in f bar. And similarly, all ones in f will be changed to zeros in f bar. For example, consider a Boolean function f, which is a or b or c. Now, when we wanted to compute f bar, we get a or b or c, the whole bar. Now we know how to apply the De Morgan's law given two variables. So we will assume that this b or c to be a single variable x. Okay, so x is equal to, we just allow this x to be b or c. So the f will become a or x. Now f bar we can compute for this substituted expression. So we get a or x the whole bar. Now we can apply the De Morgan's law and we get a bar x bar. Now we can substitute for x and we get a bar, and we have b plus c the whole bar. Now we can apply De Morgan's law once again and we get b bar c bar for this sub expression. So already we have a bar, so we have a bar b bar c bar for this function f. Instead of substituting variables for sub expressions, we can directly apply De Morgan's law if we are comfortable with. For example, if f is equal to x bar y z bar plus x bar y bar z. Now when we wanted to compute f bar, which is the complement of f, we have this expression, the whole bar. Now we can apply the De Morgan's law directly and get it like x double bar, and this AND operation will become OR operation. So we'll get x double bar plus y bar plus z double bar, because already we have z bar here, so we will get z double bar, and this OR operation will get converted to AND operation. Then we have x double bar, and this AND operation again will become OR operation, and y is already complemented here, so we will get y double bar, and then finally we have plus z bar. Now we know that x double bar is equal to x itself. When we take the complement of a variable and complement it once again, we'll get the same variable. So we have x plus y bar plus z into x. Here we have AND operation. Okay, so x plus y plus z bar. So this is directly applying the De Morgan's law to any Boolean function f. If you find it difficult to compute the complement of a function by directly applying the De Morgan's law, we can do it in two steps. First, we have to find the dual of the Boolean function and then complement each of the literal. The literal is any variable in the Boolean expression. The variable can be in the original form or in the complemented form. Either way, we call that as a literal. So for example, we consider the f, which is the same expression that we have considered already. Then the dual of this function f will be, we'll just keep the variables as such, but change the operations alone. The OR operation we will convert to AND operation, and AND operation will convert to OR operation. And if there is any zero, we'll convert it to 1, and if there is a 1, we will convert it to 0. So the dual of this f will be x bar or y or z bar, and x bar or y bar or z. Now the complement of f we can obtain by complementing each of the literal. So when you complement x bar, we will get x, or y bar, because you have y here, so you will complement and you will get y bar here, and z bar you have to complement it, so you will get z, and x bar when you complement you will get x, y bar when you complement you will get y, and z when you complement you will get z bar. Other operations will remain as such. So when you do it in two steps, it is relatively easy. These are the methods to compute the complement of a Boolean function. In the next video lecture, we will consider the ways of representing Boolean function. Thank you for watching this video.